I'd like to welcome you to the Danish Technological Institute. DTI is a self-owned company carrying out third-party testing and doing a lot of research and development projects. We are testing heat pumps, condensing units and refrigeration systems. We are really into natural refrigerants, so this is CO2, ammonia and water as refrigerant. So let's please go and say hello to our test engineer testing the Panasonic condensing unit. Hello.
This is a P&I diagram for the test setup. The diagram shows the condensing units which has been testing, and it shows the evaporator that is loading the condensing unit, and it's showing actually also the heat sink for the heat recovery system. And in this case, we are testing both. We are both testing heat recovery and evaporating capacity. And of course, we are measuring the power consumption during this test. So the setup is that we are producing liquid for our evaporator controlled by expansion device, superheat controlled. So the superheat controller is adjusting the injected liquid to the evaporator and is evaporating to a superheat of 10 degrees, and the gas is returned back to the condensing unit. The auxiliary heat for this is made by a heating element that we are heating up the glycol that is circulated through this evaporator. The evaporator is a coaxial evaporator to ensure good oil return back to the condensing unit. Entering temperature and pressure is measured. Outlet temperature and pressure is measured to have a capacity or to control the enthalpy. Safety valve is mounted. The condensing unit is a standard unit from Panasonic. We have added the water loop that is moving the heat that is produced by the condensing unit, and this is done by a pump recirculating the glycol and temperature inlet and temperature outlet and measuring of the mass flow through the unit. So this is the setup, and to control that I have a lab view interface where I can control the compressor actual running speed of the compressor. I can control the water temperature for this evaporating loop. The means of that is to control the running evaporating temperature, because this is going to be fixed in this case minus 10 degrees, and I adjust my water to match the 10 degrees, and then I of course adjust the refrigerant flow by the expansion device and the controller for the expansion device. Here I also control the speed of the pump in the heat recovery system. I can control it directly with a pump, and I also have a valve that is in series with the pump to match a very, very low flow if I want that. So during the test, I will control the ambient in order to match the SEPR statements. So the ambient will be shifted between 32 and 25 and 15 and 5 degree, and I also have a 43 degree ambient that I will measure. And by doing that, I will use the system to step through the conditions. And while doing that, I will test and record all the capacities and pressures and stuff. This is our test cell for testing the condensing unit. We have installed the condensing unit within the room, and the room is controlling the ambient temperature by an evaporator, which is removing all the produced heat from the unit. So it's a unit that we are controlling the ambient to establish the right ambient temperature for the unit. The room is also producing the heat to load the evaporator for the condensing unit. So this is there's an evaporator installed in the room for the condensing unit, and the room is also producing a heat sink for the heat recovery unit that is installed at the condensing unit. So we are actually removing the heat that is produced by the condensing unit as water heat. So it's a three-phase conditioning room. We are conditioning the room temperature and the evaporating temperature and the heat recovery conditions in one room. This is the CO2 evaporator that is connected with the condensing unit. The CO2 evaporator is heated up by glycol that is conditioned outside the room, and it is the control of refrigerant is done by an expansion device which is controlling the CO2 refrigerant through the coil. The coaxial type of evaporator provides us a good superheat control and a good oil return for all variations of capacities. Inlet conditions of CO2 is measured with the pressure and temperature, and likewise outlet conditions are measured with pressure and temperature.
So at DGI we are running a lot of R&D projects. Most of them are concerning heat pumps and refrigeration systems, and mostly industrial scale. And what is really common for these projects is natural refrigerants. So it's ammonia, it's CO2, and it's water, and some propane as well. So thank you very much for visiting DGI. Hope to see you soon. Bye.